everyone, this is Disha here, and today we are going to perform an activity, that is, we are going to control the virtual devices you can see in the classroom, for example, a fan or a lamp. If I want to control the fan, I can just click on the on command, and you can see the fan is on. Or if I want to control the lamp, you can see in the classroom, as I want to turn on the lamp, you can see the lamp is turned on. So today we are going to perform this activity using some machine learning concept. So to proceed with, firstly, we will write some rules for controlling the devices. Then we will learn that why that approach isn't that good. Then we'll teach our computer to recognize the commands by itself so that we can control the virtual devices. So this learning teaching part is generally known as machine learning. That is, we will train our computer to recognize the commands you will give it to it. So let's start our project. Firstly, I'll select the project from project templates as smart classroom. You can see here the virtual devices appear here. Firstly, click on the classroom sprite since I want to state my rules for the computer. Firstly, I want my computer to ask me about the command I want to perform over here on this devices. So for this command giving asking question, there is a block in Scratch, that is ask block. Let us use it. So here it is, the ask block. For example, if I would run this block, you can see a dialog box will appear here asking your name. But I want my computer to ask me about the command. So I'll write over here as, write your command. So let's check it. You can see my computer is now asking about my command as write your command. And I can state the command over here. For example, if I will write the command as turn on the fan, you can see nothing is happening here. It is so because I have not stated any rule to be performed over these devices. So let us state the rules to perform an activity using these devices. For this, I would firstly use the block if then block. In case you haven't heard about if then block, so it performs like if the condition mentioned over here is to be true, then it would perform an activity that is stated over here. For example, if I want to place a condition using some operator like, I want my answer of this command, my answer of this command as turn on the fan. For example, if the command given here is turn on the fan should be turned on. For example, let us check over here. Write a command. I would state here as turn on the fan. Look over here. Nothing happened. Why? Because it's just checking the condition that if the answer to this question is turn on the fan, the condition is true. But what after this condition? So after this condition, I have to broadcast the message to the code that if the condition is true, then turn on the fan. So for this, there is another block, that is broadcast block. So I'll click on fan on. For example, if the condition or if the answer of this question is turn on the fan, it would broadcast the message to the fan to be turned on. Let us check it. Write your command. Turn on the fan. You can see the fan is on. But what after this? If I want to stop or switch off this fan, I have to state another condition to switch off the fan. So I'll again repeat the same process to switching off the fan. So again, I'll use if then block, check my condition of my answer as turn off the fan. I want to broadcast the message. If the condition is true, it would broadcast the message of turning fan off, and I would place this block over here. So let us run the code again. Write your command. Let us check the turning off condition. Turn off the fan. You can see the fan is off. But can you see, if now I want to again run this code, I have to again click this code. But I want this loop to be continuously forever asking me that if your command is being changed, or if I want to change this command. So for this, there is another loop, that is forever loop. If I would place this whole block inside a forever loop, it will continuously, it will always keep on checking the command section that if the command is changed or if the condition is again and again true, then it will perform that activity. For example, write a command. I wrote a command over here is turn on the fan. You can see again I can change my command. For example, turn off the fan. Nice. So the fan is off. Now we will repeat the same situation with the lamp. I'll again use the if then block for my fan, for my lamp. I'll use the operator to check my condition. What I'll check is my answer as turn on the lamp. And if the condition is true, it should broadcast the message to the code, that is turn the lamp on. And I will place this whole code in the forever loop. I'll repeat again for the turning off the lamp. So again, go to control section, if then block, again the operator section to check the condition, placed over here. Check my answer to the question as turn off the lamp, and if the condition is true, it should broadcast the message as turn off the lamp. Again, I'll put this whole thing into forever loop. What I want is, it should be performed when I would click the green flag. Now, let us click on the green flag to run our code. Okay, nice. So my computer is asking me a question about write your command. For example, now let me check to turn on the fan. Nice. I want to check my lamp to be switched on. Okay, it's working. Let us try some another condition. For example, if I wrote over here as switch on the or switch off the fan. You can see the fan is not switched off. It's so because the condition mentioned in this block is off, turn off the fan. The statement I wrote is not matching the condition, therefore nothing happened over here. So till now what we have done here is, we have stated some of the rules. For example, I have mentioned the turn on the fan, etc. rules to be performed my computer. But there is something which is not right. If some other person will write over the command which is similar to the meaning of turn on the fan or turn off the fan, it will not work. So let's try another approach to solve this problem. So my another approach is, we can teach our computer to get familiar with the similar commands over given over here. So let's solve this problem of our similar commands. So for this, what I have to do is, I'll visit to back to the project, and what I have to do is, I have to train my computer to recognize the similar commands. So I'll click on the train block, and here what I have to do is I will mention similar examples. For example, I will collect more and more example so that it could recognize the similar commands. So let us do that. For example, add a new label. I'm labeling over here as fan on. You can see a bucket appears here. I can add on the examples that is similar to the situation of fan on. For example, I'll add the example of as if I want a command like please turn on the fan, and my fan should be turned on. Or maybe some other person would be like to say as turn on fan. Or maybe I want to say like switch on. Switch on the fan. And let us say add another similar phrase like it's too hot here. So please turn on the fan like. Or maybe I can add some more examples like please switch on the fan and maybe like it's heating over here. Switch on the fan. You can create some more, you can add some more example as you wish. I'm just checking the more examples, and let us make another label for my fan to be off. I would add example like, firstly I would like to write turn off the fan. Then I would like to write a switch off the fan. Or maybe if I have to request someone, so I would like to write please switch off the fan. Or maybe I want to like it's too cold here. Or maybe like it's breezy. Or maybe please make the room colder. Or you can add some more example according to you. Let us add another label for my lamp to be on. Label as lamp on. You can see here the bucket. You can add the example like turn on the lamp or switch on the lamp or please make the room lighter or maybe it's too dark. Let us say if I want to write please add some light. Or lights on. So try to add every type of similar phrase you can found like creative. For example, now my one of the label is missing, that is lamp off. So I will again write turn off the lamp I have to add the example and write. Switch off the lamp. Or maybe as turn off the lamp. Or it's too light over here. Or maybe simple as lights off. Or I can request someone like, please turn off the lights. Or please switch. Maybe I want to write switch off. The lights. And for example, it's too much light here. Okay, you can add as much as examples you want to add, but for now I'm adding some of the examples. And what I'll do is I'll click on the back to project and I'll make my computer to learn from those examples and recognize the similar commands given to the computer. So let us just make our computer to learn and test. So, okay. So train new machine model. So it will take some time. Till then we will revise what we have done so far. Firstly, we wrote some of the rules using if-then blocks stating some of the condition. But we faced one problem over there, that is, if the command is similar but doesn't match in the condition we gave in the if-then block, the activity is not performed. So we have to add on more and more if-then block to state every familiar possibility. But it's like it will take forever time. It's really impossible to add on all the similar commands. So for that, we are training our computer to match these similar commands. How the computer will match is, I am stating some of the example so that my computer will recognize the similar examples and make the activity to be performed. So I am training my computer to follow the patterns of the example and understand the commands given over there. So I guess it's just training. Till then I'll make you clear that this type of learning is generally called supervised learning. It's so because I am making my computer to be supervisedly learning how it's learning from the patterns, because I gave the examples so that computer could recognize the pattern. This type of machine learning is called supervised learning. So, I guess this machine is trained. So, let us check some of the condition and test how our machine is trained. For example, let us write over here one command as fan on. It will be recognizing as 91% confidence. That means it is 91% of the chance that this command is matching some of our example and the activity can be performed. Now, what I have to do is, let's make our machine learning model to be executed. So, I'll go on the make section. So now, let us use our trained machine model instead of using this rules-based approach. So for this, I'll click on the Smart Classroom, that is my project, and use some of the labels written over here. So firstly, in the place of answer, I would use as recognize text and now text in answer. And here, I would use as the fan on condition. Again, I'll repeat the same process. I'll use this recognize text, and the text part is the answer, and again I'll use the fan off. Repeat this process. Recognize text, text as answer, and again lamp on, and again the same process. Repeat. Instead of this, I will write as answer, and here lamp off. What we are doing here is, I'm recognize the text of my answer in label. If you remember, during the process of training, we created some four labels and mentioned some of the examples there. So what my machine is doing, it's recognizing the text from the label and then performing some action. So now let us learn this machine learning model. Let us try and run this. So let us write as switch on the fan. You can see the fan is working. Or if I would like to write as lights on, you can see the lamp here is on. So you can test multiple commands over here. So what we have done is, we have trained our machine model and we have tested the machine model here. So as you see that our model is running so good, we have tested some of the commands and it's performing well. Now let us again check the condition from the testing scene. So firstly, I would save this project to my computer. Then I'll click on back to project and we will say learn and test our conditions. So what if I would write some other condition, like I want cheese sandwich, and let us test this command. So you can see here, it is recognized as lamp on. So this command, what it will perform as, it will switch the lamp on. But we don't want this. And you can see the confidence score, that is 10%. What this confidence score is, it's matching the conditions from our examples. So it's 10% matching from lamp on example in the labels. But I don't want this to be performed because it's very wrong. So what I will do is, I'll modify this scratch code again. So I'll click back to project and I'll make this project from scratch 3. Open in scratch 3. What we will do is, since we have saved our project, we will run it from our computer. So what I have to do here is, I have to modify some of the command so that if the confidence score is less than 70% or let's say less than 80%, there should be no activity performed over here. So as you can see, our saved project appears here. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm using another block, that is if else block. Let us see. From the control section, I would drag a block, if then block, and I would like to place it here. What is this block is doing is, if some condition over here is true, it will perform an activity, else it will perform this activity. So I want the condition to be like, if my confidence score that we checked in the test section is less than 70%, the activity should not be performed in the classroom. So what I'll do here is, I'll use an operator for checking my condition, an operator of less than, and I'll use over here is, to check my confidence score, I used the recognized text as confidence score, and in the text what it will check is my answer. Now here I will write as 70%. So now my condition is, if the recognized text from the command is less than 70% confidence score, it would like to say, let's say it, say, let's say, sorry, I am not sure what you mean, for 2 seconds. Okay, so if the confidence score is less than 70%, my computer should print like sorry, I'm not sure. Or else if the confidence score is 70, more than 70%, it will perform this activity. Let us again run our code from the green flag. And I would like to write here is, I want cheese sandwich. So now you can see nothing is performed over here because our command is wrong. And what was it printing was for 2 seconds that sorry, I'm not sure. Let us say it would print for 10 seconds. So that you can see, let me run again and let me check for another command like cheese sandwich. So, sorry, I'm not sure what you mean. So now, our machine learning model is completely trained and it would always perform the activity only when there are more than 70% chances that it will match some of the example or condition. So now let us summarize what we have done so far. Firstly, we wrote some if-then blocks. Using if-then blocks, we wrote some of the rules or conditions for the commands. Then we got to know that if there are some another commands given by some another person and it is not matching, their activity would not be performed. So to resolve that problem, we use machine learning technique of supervised learning and gave some of the examples to our machine to learn from that patterns and recognize the commands. Then we checked the commands and it was performing well. But there was again a problem, or we can say again an error, that was, if I am stating some of the command and it is matching some of the example from the label, it is doing some of the random activity and I don't want that. So what I have done over here is, I have used a block for confidence score checking and I have used the condition as if else block conditions, it would check the confidence score. Then only it would perform the activity. So we use machine learning concept because it's much easy and much quicker than if then or any rules based approach.